Hi, Rakeysh and Prakash Mehra from me, Hrishi K, and everybody at Radio 1. Thank you for this interview.
Hey, Hrishi, how are you?
Very well. What does Rezgariya mean? I mean, it's one of those amazing stuff, things that Gulzar Saab writes.
No, he's been doing it for, it feels like hundreds of years. And it also feels like it will stay, whatever he writes will stay for thousands of years. Rezgariya means chillad, means loose change. जो हमारे 5 पैसा 10 पैसा 25 पैसा 50 पैसे के सिक्के होते हैं ना जिनको कहीं रख के भूल जाते हैं जो जेब से गिर भी जाएं तो हमें फ़र्क नहीं पड़ेगा शायद हम सोचेंगे भी नहीं दो बार तो हमारे जो स्ट्रीट के बच्चे हैं स्लम के बच्चे दे लाइक रेजगारियाँ दे लाइक चिल्लर कि उनके बारे में कोई सोचता नहीं वो बिखरे पड़े समथिंग लाइक दैट इट्स अ ब्यूटिफुल सॉन्ग obviously penned by Gulzar Bhai and what is it is like the soul of the film it describes the film and what is very very special for me is that for the first time we have Shivam and Shankar you know father son duo of course it's Shankar Ehsaan Noorani the music that in itself is what an amazing platform but other than that For the first time, is Shankar and Shivam singing the song together?
Yeah, Shankar Mahadevan, wonderful talking to you. I asked Shan this because very recently for some animation project, him and one of the boys was singing together, you know, yeah. One of those Disney kind of projects. And he said that he actually checks his son's iPod to cue himself into the cool music and not. So do you have that kind of relationship with Sid? I mean, do you listen to a good tune?
I don't need to check his iPod or iPhone, but because he keeps playing all the latest stuff, and when anybody releases anything worldwide, he comes to know first, and he plays it for me, and we listen to it together, and he's completely, and he plays it so loud that. You don't have an option but to listen to it, can't speak in between also. So, you get educated. No.
By force.
No, not by force. It's a great thing, yeah.
Rakeysh made a very interesting comment at the trailer launch, I think it was, saying that it's quite rare and, to see father and son like this, Kishorda and Amit Kumar never managed to get a song together. You know, Mukesh Saab and Nitin Mukesh never managed for that to happen. You are not the kind of person who gives very great importance and you know things to things like this. How was it?
But were you able at all? It was Rakesh's idea, and thanks to Rakesh, thanks to my two brothers here, Ehsaan and Loy, for making this possible. Because I would never say that you know I want to sing a song with my son and promote my son in the film or anything like that. That's the last thing that I ever do. But he gave an opportunity, and I thought this is this was a correct song because of the kind of film it is, what it's saying, and it's I think it is a wonderful message that is coming through this song, and you know he is quite good that way. So. He's managed very well, yeah.
So the there's no veto power in this band or in this trio, because I remember when I think during Karthik or was it during Zindagi, he was saying that about Alicia, saying that you know I didn't want her to sing, but these two guys said that.
He didn't even know that she was going to.
He didn't even know. So how are these decisions taken? Is my question.
You know, I think that the song kind of dictates best who will sing it. You know, I mean, whoever will come and sing it, whether it is Alisa or Shivam, they came and sang it badly, then there would be a problem. You know what I mean? But they sung it well and they're good singers, so you trust them to do that also. But, you know, having said that, it's really the song that dictates who will sing it. You know?
Very beautifully put. I'm stunned by the fact that, you know, there's a completely new cast, apart from Mac and maybe Anjali, this bunch of kids. This other guy who's Anjali's love interest, here are you work with these mega stars and things like that. You seem to be having the time of your life working with this bunch of kids and the new actors in this.
Yeah. So, ain't it beautiful? Like, absolutely. Working with children. And after a long time, I think I don't remember a film for a longest time where the mother and son are the hero and heroine of the film. So, the hero is an 8-year-old. And the heroine is a 24-year-old single mother. Last time we did Bhag Milka Bhag and we did the music together. The hero and heroine were brother and sisters. So everyone told me, you know, now when you think back at Bhag Milka Bhag, Rishi, it was the sister who was the heroine of the film as such. So these are, you know, here it is something which the women face every day. That's what the issue the film kind of is trying to voice. Especially the women living in the lower strata of the society, the have-nots in the slums. There's some startling figures about violation of women, rape, balatkar. And this is when it happens to the mother. The eight-year-old takes it upon himself to change things. It's very inspiring to see the way he goes about it. He would not stop at anything, even if he has to write a letter to Mere Pyare Prime Minister and deliver it by hand, by taking a train to Delhi with his friends. Or those bhi kamal ke unko ek ka naam nirala, ek ka naam ringtone. So, ye sab street ke bachche hain, sab rezgariyan hain. Aap ek इस प्रोग्राम में आप ज़रूर रिक्वेस्ट कीजिए शंकर को वो गाएं वो गाना. आज शिवम नहीं है, नहीं तो और भी मज़ा आता, बट फिर भी
नहीं वो तो होगा ही 100%. बट आई वांट आस्क यू दिस, यू नो द फैक्ट दैट अरिजीत इज़ वर्किंग विद यू गाइज ऑन दिस, द टाइटल ट्रैक इज़ हिज. आई वाज एक्चुअली, यू नो, बिकॉज आई हैव सीन यू गाइज इन कॉन्सर्ट सो मेनी टाइम्स एंड यू कम विद अ फुल बैंड एंड यू नो यू डू योर बैंड थिंग एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट. आई थिंक दिस वॉज एट द NSC ग्राउंड्स इन गोरेगांव. द गाय केम विद अ फुल बैंड एंड ही हैड अ लाइक अ चेलो प्लेयर एंड ऑर्केस्ट्रा एंड ही इज़ क्वाइट अ रॉकर, इज़न्ट ही?
He's a fantastic musician. And the thing is that, you know, when we heard him a couple of years ago, many years ago, and we Shankar actually spotted him, and you know, when I heard him, I said, this guy is amazing, because he is so focused, he's so dedicated, and the best part of it, he's so humble, he's so down to earth, so rude. When you look at him, he's got none of the star BS that other people have. You know, because he knows that he's truly a good artist. You don't need to have all that additional baggage, because it's not required. He just focuses on delivering and doing what he does, and does it so beautifully.
On that note, Shankar, raise Garia, please.
I think do it in the A only, boss, because then you will cut it to the song, no?
रेजगारियां बजने लगी रेजगारियां रे ओए रेजगारियां रे हो सच्ची बोला हम लोगा फुटपाथ की कोई जात नहीं रे ओए रेजगारियां रे खाली जेबें रेजगारियां बजती हैं जिंदगी अजीब है गरीब नहीं रे ओए रेजगारियां बजने लगी रेजगारियां रे
स्वीट. Rakesh, I was speaking to Zoya because she also filmed predominantly in chawls and slums for the film that just came out. And she said it's the most difficult thing anybody can do. And your slum seems to be even tighter. This is Ghatkopar, right?
It's Khanduba Hill, so it's on a hill. So it is there. And we shot 100% in the slum. Even the indoor scenes, we didn't create a set. We shot in 10 by 12 kholis.
Or you took all your gear
Yeah.
In those small kholis, you took your lights, your sound, everything, and you set up. And so there were no separate makeup bands or anything. So just the atmosphere of filming there.
It was wonderful. It was beautiful. It was, people were so helpful. And each, they not only opened their homes to us, they opened their hearts. And each kholi you have to see is 10 by 10 or 10 by 12, you know, aise karke. और उसी में एक मेकअप रूम हो जाता था, एक में इक्विपमेंट रख के रात को चले जाते थे, और फिक्र भी नहीं होता था. मतलब खाना वो लोग बना के हमको खिलाते थे, और उन्होंने जिन्होंने 3-4 ऐसे 10 घर खाली किए, उन्होंने वहीं पे 10 घर और किराए पे ले लिए. बट अपना सारा सामान वहाँ छोड़ के गए. वी वर शूटिंग विद देयर प्रॉपर्टी बिकॉज वी डिडंट वांट टू मेक इट लुक फिल्मी. तो इट वाज अ जॉय शूटिंग देयर. देयर वाज नो डिफिकल्टी व्हाटसोएवर. इफ देयर इज अ डिफिकल्टी तो हम तो वहाँ आए गए मेहमान है ना, 40 दिन शूटिंग की निकल गए, वापस अपने बंगलों में बिल्डिंग्स में पहुँच गए, एसी रूम में. आप फिर डिफ़िकल्टी उनकी सोचिए जो वहाँ रहते हैं, जो ज़िंदगी बिता देते हैं, जिनका बचपन वहाँ गुजरता है, बुढ़ापा वहाँ गुजरता है. अगर आप 60-80 साल के बूढ़े हैं, आपको लगता है कि मैं घर की दो सीढ़ियाँ कैसे उतरूँगा, बाथरूम कैसे जाऊँगा. अब आप सोचिए पूरा पहाड़ आपको उतर के नीचे जाना है. तो डिफ़िकल्टी तो उनकी दर्शाने की मैंने कोशिश की. वो आपको महसूस हो जाए तो कहीं ना कहीं मैं 10% सफल हो जाऊँगा.
So Rakesh must be your go-to person. Like he just has to pick up the phone and say, "Let's do this," and it happens without any, "Hey, what's the film about? What's the soundtrack about?"
Actually, you know, it just happens. One project merges into the other. You won't believe it. As we were doing these interviews over here, we've already started sitting in this room only composing for the next film. So that's how it happens with Rakesh. I mean, work happens anywhere, anyhow. There is no bandhan. There is no. I mean, serious work happens in a very non-serious environment. And we all. I mean, at the end of the day, we are making music. Yeah, so you know, we are having a great time.
Ehsaan, this album has 4 songs only, and one of them is kind of like a recreation of an old hit, which I believe is an homage to V. Shantaram and to C. Ramchandra, which we will talk about. In that aspect, it's very different from Bhag Milkha Bhag, which was a proper, huge, large-scale, intricate album. So the differences in this one and that one?
Well, actually, Bhag Milkha Bhag, I mean, like you said, it's a sports film, it's international, it's, you know, very big. And in international in the sense that it's shot all over the world, you know, that kind of thing. And actually, that needed a particular kind of scale. This narrative needed to be more intimate. Now in this case, especially that holy song that you're talking about, what's the song called by the way?
Jare Ja Natkhat, no, but the original is?
Baja 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 Dhol Baja Re.
Baja Baja.
Dhapli Baji, Kanjari Baji, Khol Baja Re. Thodi Thodi Bhangodi, Thoda Thoda Rangoda. Ek Dam, Ek Drum, Roll Baja Re, Ja Ja Re Natkhat.
I was actually listening to the car on the way here. It's quite a cool song. Lyrically also, it's quite cool.
We didn't want to touch the original work of the great maestro, and we didn't want to, you know, recreate it by somebody else singing it and all. So what we've done is we've taken the original song itself and just placed it over there and merged the rest of the track with it, rather than, you know, recreating it and all. So it's an ode to V. Shantaram, which always Rakesh wanted to.
You're a big fan, aren't you? I mean, from his days in Raj Kamal, did you manage to spend time with him, or were you just hanging around there?
No, but these are my advertising days, and we used to shoot a lot in Raj Kamal, and I used to see Shantaram Saab. He stayed there only. It was like a temple to us, and we used to see him from far. Dar lagta tha ki unke nazdeek bhi jana aur baat karne ki to baat hi bahut dur thi. उनकी गैलरी है जहाँ उनके सारे अवार्ड सर्टिफिकेट्स फिल्म के पोस्टर हैं. मैं जब भी वहाँ जाता था तो एक आध घंटों बीत जाते थे वहीं बैठ के देखता रहता था लंच ब्रेक में. एंड आई लर्न्ड माय सिनेमा थ्रू हिज सिनेमा. ही इज़ माय इंस्पिरेशन अमंग मेनी अदर मास्टर्स. मतलब यू कैन काउंट देम ऑन योर फिंगर्स. इज वी शांताराम और सब कुरुसावा और सब फेलिनी और सब गुरुदत्त or Kislowski. These are great guys. And V. Shantaram, what the music, when I think of music, I don't write the music. It's written by Shankar Ehsaan and Loy and Gulzar Bhai. But when I think of something, it's what comes to me as an inspiration is V. Shantaram, the way he used music in his film. You know, and his films are like Yusi Pinjara, Dua Ke Bara Haath, Malik Tere Bande Hum, you know, so in Navrang there is this song for Holi. This is Ja Ja Re Hat Nat Khat, Chhod Re Mera Ghungat, Palat Ke Dungi Aat Tujhe Gari Re. So I requested Shankar Ehsaan Loy and Gulzar Bhai, and they were very happy to accept that as an ode in their original composition. And how to bring that ode into it feels like seamless. Lagta hai aaj hi record hua kyunki usko chheda nahi bilkul.
Lovely. Can you do the title track for me? Little bit? Yeah? Okay.
ये खुदा सुबह सुबह जगाता है मंदिरों में वो सुबह घंटियां बजाता है सुनता नहीं है बहरा नहीं तो गूंगा नहीं तो कहता नहीं क्यों तुम ही सुनो मेरे प्यारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर मेरी एक अर्जी सुन लो जरा मेरे प्यारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर आगे तेरी मर्जी सुन लो जरा
Beautiful. Which brings me to the kid and how there are, I have only the trailer and a couple of promos to go by. How he actually, you know, there's a problem in his life and how he and his friends get together and they say, Gandhiji se poochte hain. Or, you know, should we get in touch with, somebody can help me and this and that. And we've actually done that in my building society where we've turned around to the kids and said, if you see the elders littering, catch them, you know. So there's so much power in children coming together.
Oh, absolutely. I always believe that change begins with yourself, and that's why the film is inspired by Gandhiji. That's the first frame when the film will begin. Children are innocent, they're clever. That doesn't mean they don't lie. बहुत बदमाश भी होते हैं अपना काम करवाने के लिए कुछ भी करेंगे. तो ये कहानी ऐसी है जो हमें बहुत प्रेरित करती है. Through their his journey, through Kannu's journey for his single mother, Sargam. And वो गांधी जी वाला सीन बहुत प्यारा है. इन्हें ये स्लम्स में रहते थे, those planes ना, they land very close to you. You could almost jump and touch them. It feels like that. तो रोज़ शाम को ये लोग बैठ के planes गिनते हैं. तो अब कन्नू बहुत dejected है. वो एक प्लेन जा रहा है तो कहता है, यार ये प्लेन में भी टॉयलेट होते हैं. सो मंगला रिप्लाइज, और क्या, बड़े बड़े लोग क्या इतनी देर रोक के रखेंगे. भगवान ने ना हम सबको एक सा बनाया, तो बस फर्क इतना है वो लोग प्लेन में करते हैं, हम लोग पटरी पे करते हैं. सो रिंग टोन हिज फ्रेंड अंडरस्टैंड्स कि कन्नू गुस्से में है, थोड़ा डिजेक्टेड है, फ्रस्ट्रेटेड है, उसका काम बन नहीं रहा है, दिल्ली भी होके आ गए, काम नहीं हो रहा है. कहते है, टेंशन मत ले यार, तेरा काम हो जाएगा. कहते है, कौन करेगा? तेरा बाप. मंगला कहते नहीं, हम सब का बापू. तो कौन? गांधी जी. गांधी जी तो कब के मर चुके. एंड शी टेक्स आउट 100 रुपी नोट एंड शोज गांधी जी प्रिंटेड. सो ट्राइंग टू से द वैल्यूज इज गांधी जी गेव अस टुडे, आवर वैल्यू सिस्टम हैज कम डाउन टू, वी नीड लॉट ऑफ गांधीज इन रुपीज बट नॉट इन द वैल्यू सिस्टम. सो समवेयर देयर इज अ रिमाइंडर टू, अरे गांधी जी की भी सुन लो जरा.
Just Anjali Patil, in working with her, she's such an accomplished actress. I believe she's from the National School of Drama. She's trained and she's playing a young single mother here. Seems to be a fabulous performance.
Anjali is godsend, and I always believe that there is a conspiracy theory in the universe that the right people get together, do the right thing. So when your intentions are correct, all falls in place. She's a national award winner. She's a president gold medal winner from Sri Lanka for her Sri Lankan film. She's won the best actress award at the London Film Festival. So she, at a very young age, has achieved a lot in alternate cinema and regional cinema. Now, I think with this film, she's made a mark. It's like a lifetime performance. I hope so. Of all the work I've seen, I'm very proud. and also very grateful that I got to work with her. She didn't play the part, she became the part, and it was crazy to see that even 1 month before she came and she said, what am I wearing, what are the sarees, and after that she would come to the office, travel in second class trains, walk the slums, just to understand ki what is her body language, what she'll do. So there was a lot of effort there, a lot of hard work. Talent, no question, that's 100% here.
How did you get the kids? I mean, did you test for them or are they actual slum kids?
Some of them are from the slums, and one is from a rehabilitated slum, two are from the slums, not the same slums that are around Bombay. And the girl is not, but she understood. We did all our workshops and we did it. There were a shortlisting. Then out of those, these four stood out. And we spent a lot of time together and just hanging out with each other, winning each other's trust, friendship. And so the shooting just followed after that.
Okay, last couple of questions because I think my time is up. We're doing a... उसको और कराने इंटरव्यू पीछे से इशारे कर सो सी वी डूइंग एन इनिशिएटिव एट द रेडियो स्टेशन कॉल्ड हील द वर्ल्ड वी वर सेइंग हाउ कैन यू प्रोटेक्ट द एनवायरनमेंट एंड यू डूइंग समथिंग अमेजिंग यू आर एसोसिएटेड विद एन एनजीओ यू आर बिल्डिंग टॉयलेट्स आरंट यू सो जस्ट अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट दैट
अब नो नथिंग दैट्स आई एम डूइंग नथिंग दैट हैजंट बीन डन बिफोर देयर इज आई हैव स्टार्टेड अ प्रोजेक्ट कॉल्ड the India Toilet Project with Rotary Foundation, and before that I'm associated with another NGO from Ahmedabad called Yuva, where we've already adopted 1,000 schools, built around 6,000-7,000 toilets, but that's beside the point. What you are doing about at your end with the power of radio, I think you are making such a huge difference, and that's beautiful. We also have a small initiative, Rishi, with this film, with Mere Pyare Prime Minister, which is releasing on 15th March, is PM Ko Chitti, hashtag PM Ko Chitti. So already 40,000 letters have come in 2 days. So aapke dil mein jo bhi hai aur aapko PM ko bolna hai, wo aap PM Ko Chitti likhe. There's a whole team which is scanning, and those 50 letters I will personally take to the Prime Minister of India and present it to him. From the citizens of India, so that I have taken the responsibility of.
How cool is that? Just one thing, that a small thing we can do to save the environment. Yeah, for example, this is an actor called Ronit Roy was in my studio last week, and he said an amazing thing. He said, in my house, the kids are not allowed to open a plastic packet and eat out of it. It could be something as small as that. What can we do?
Well, a simple thing like we all drink water. You can carry your own kind of bottle to work, because that's a huge, the amount of plastic bottles is way out of whack. I mean, if I rewind 30 years ago, that didn't exist. And in 30 years, it's like, oof.
Thank you, Lloyd. Thanks. Yeah. Thanks. Shankar, what can we do? Small thing to save the environment?
As in eradication of plastic, you say?
Anything. Do you have a garden at home?
I have a garden in my farmhouse, yeah. So, I think in our day-to-day lives, from the time we wake up till the time we sleep, if we focus on little things that we do and see any of those actions are harming the environment and whether we can stop it. While brushing, keep the tap open, stuff like that. You keep the tap open all the time when you're shaving, that the water is running. Small things like that. So, I mean, use bottle, as Loy said, use your own bottle to carry water. Small stuff, yeah.
Thank you, Shankar.
See, the thing is, what I found is that, which I realized on World Earth Day, when we were watching this concert going on television, I think the Live 8 or something was going on at the same time, or one of those concerts that was, being telecast worldwide, that I didn't realize that even leaving a switch on with nothing plugged into it is wasting electricity. The electricity is still flowing there. And how much? Of course, it does. And I just realized that you've got to put everything off. And which I, make sure at night, little switchboards and stuff which you take for granted that your modems are plugged into it, you leave it on because you want it to be. I make sure I shut all that down because it's still, that all that stuff is using up electricity, which in turn is using up water. and which in turn is we give, you know, using up more coal, you know, or more nuclear energy, you know. So it's it all goes a long way, you know, little things. So I make sure I do that kind of stuff. Even taking a shower, you know, I put the shower off and I'm soaping and stuff like that, and then, you know, again, and actually a shower, I realize you can take a shower like literally in, you know, 2 minutes, you know, yeah, and you're completely clean, you know.
Thank you, gentlemen. All the best for Mere Pyare Prime Minister. Thank you.